So when we did this piece 45 years ago, and when we did it more recently in the current incarnation, people have been saying, was this really written in 1924? It seems incredibly prescient. And the things that have been coming together just in the last few days, you know, we suddenly had the end of the government shutdown. Why? I think in part because the TSA people were threatening a general strike, which was what Rosa Luxemburg was calling for. And this is it. The water won't comply no longer. That's it. I mean, you've got the, you know, the essence of what's happening right now in what we just did. Right? We have about 3 minutes for questions. Anybody?
Yeah, we all went shopping together.
This has been a very unusual chorus. In fact, this is the first time we usually had about 8 women and 4 men. And in this chorus, we have 7 or 8 women and 10 or 12 men. So it's really been like a luxury, you know? And the women that we have are dressed great, and the men are, you know, really solid. So, the Metropolitan Philharmonic Chorus. This is our 50th performance. First one was back in 1988 by Rosenberg and Tom. The second one was I Have a Dream at the Harlem School of the Arts. Are there questions for anybody else?
It takes some concentration.
Bertolt Brecht wrote the play, The Roundheads and the Pointerheads. He rewrote it 8 times. In fact, when it was done in East Berlin for the first time, I was there, and they announced, Die Rundköpfe, die Spitzköpfe, Spieldauer, 8,5 Stunden. Narration, 8.5 hours. Because if you did all the drafts that he wrote together, that's how long it would be. When we did it at Cornell, we reduced it from 5 hours to 3 hours. Then in 1998, from the Brecht and the Isocentennial, we decided to do, we took the note of a note that Brecht had written where he said the whole piece could be done with six singers, so the whole score. So we did the whole score, but we took out the play. We just had this, you know, and that's what you hear today. And in fact, Eric Bentley, who for many years published the only translation of Roundhead's Plays, which was written by somebody named N. Gut Verschuyler in Moscow in 1935, who was probably killed by Stalin, wrote the only published English version of it. Was Grove Press wrote it out, and Eric Bentley held the royalties in escrow. But it's a terrible translation of a terrible draft. And this play is just so incredible, and because the score is so incredible. I mentioned in the program notes that 4 of the 14 numbers were never published, and we couldn't rent them unless we had a production. We couldn't have a production unless we had the score. So what did I do? I went to East Berlin, and I asked them to let me photocopy. They wouldn't let me photocopy. I asked them to let me photograph. They wouldn't let me photograph it. They let me copy it out by hand. I sat there all day and did that. And 4 of these numbers are in my handwriting. Yeah. That's the only one. Right? What are they afraid of? Well, that's a good question. You know, when I brought when they did this piece in East Berlin for the first time, I was living in West Berlin. I called up the director and I said, would you like to hear the recording that we made of this in Toronto? I'd love to have him over. And I stopped at the border, and they wouldn't let me through. They said, you can't bring a recording into a non-commercial recording into the DDR. I said, wait a minute! The man who wrote this score wrote your national anthem. You have to let this through. And then, you know what they did? They took it and listened to it. They made me sit there for 45 minutes while they apparently played the whole thing. And then they made me sign a statement that I would bring it in and take it out. And the director had to sign a statement that said that he would not dub it. And he laughed. He looked at it and he said, I signed a statement, I will not dub it. He handed it to the music director and said, you dub it. What were they afraid of, you know? That the wall might come tumbling down, which it did 6 years later, right?